say Canada denied them visa, most likely they have committed one or two errors in their visa application. I can guarantee that. So if you want to reapply for Canada visa, you have to watch this video or watch it again. How are you doing today? With you here is Dr. Linda Iheme, and I'll be talking to you various matters that borders on Canada visa. And what I'm saying today is going to be especially helpful to anybody who has applied to Canada visa before or has applied for Canada visa before and was denied. This training is for you. This is actually a training. I'm going to be leaking a lot of secrets, so pay special attention, okay? My name is Dr. Linda Iheme. I'm an educational consultant with Vantage Migration. Myself and my team, we train graduates on how to secure admission, scholarship, study loan abroad all by yourself without any agent, irrespective of your grade. All right, so if you fall into this category, feel free to start with our free webinar at www.vantagemigration.ca. All right, www.vantagemigration.ca. Some people say, why is Canada visa hard to get? And I'm talking study visa, visiting visa, business visa. Why is Canada visa hard to get? And the answer that comes top of my mind is, Canada is a fine bride. A lot of people want to go to Canada because of the great things that Canada offer. For example, students can stay, become permanent residents, become citizens within period of 3 to 4 years, depending on the study they are going for. Bear in mind, we handle graduates. So most times when I'm talking to graduates. If you're an undergraduate, listen to what I'm saying, but I'm talking to graduates, okay? So Canada is a fine bride. There are a lot of people coming to Canada. There are a lot of people that want Canada because Canada immigration policies are awesome, especially for immigrants. I am a living testimony. Canada is awesome. So everybody wants to go to Canada, right? However, Canada will accept you only when you do the right thing. So because everybody wants to go to Canada, that means every Tom, Dick and Harry is applying for Canada visa, which means that a lot of people are going to get denial as well, like visa denied. But I want to tell you something, especially if it is not you who have applied for visa before. The next time somebody tells you, my visa was denied, don't take that surface answer. Don't take that surface comment, because there is usually more to it. People like to omit their mistakes, omit whatever they did, and you will just go with the right. Ah, really? Canada denied it. That means they will deny me too. But who said they are going to deny you visa? Nobody. You're just imposing your friend's experience on yourself, and that's not the best way to live life. You already know, right? So when people say Canada denied them visa, most likely they have committed one or two errors in their visa application. I can guarantee that. Like, I can guarantee. If 100 people got visa denial, I don't even want to say that there is one person whose visa was denied by mistake. But I'm going to say that even if there is that one person whose visa was denied because they just denied the visa, it doesn't happen. I'm just saying, just to eliminate error, right? It will be one out of the 100. The other 99, when you start asking them about their document, even you be ashamed, like, somebody submitted their visa like this in this world right now. Okay, so I always say that Canada visa officers are humans. Treat them like humans that they are. A lot of people think, oh, Canada visa officers are irrational fishes, like fish that you eat. They think that visa officers are fishes with fish brain. They don't know anything. If you just bamboozle them like this, they'll just give you visa. If they smoke, then they are going to be so high, they're not going to give you visa. It doesn't work like that. It does not work like that. I guarantee you, it does not work like that. Stop treating Canada visa officers as if they are fishes. I always say this. You know, even if you are the one, when somebody treats you like you're a fish, you know how angry you get, right? So they are human beings, treat them like that. What do I mean by that? For example, you're going to see somebody who just somebody's account is empty. 2 days before they applied for visa, 60 million naira entered. Then, 2 days after account statement is printed and submitted, guess what they are going to tell you? I submitted my visa. There was a lot of money in my account. I even have up to 60 million naira. What they did not tell you is that that 50 million naira entered a day or 2 days before they submitted the account. In fact, 1 month before. A fish will say you have 60 million. A human being will say, how come you never had money all your life? Until a month before the day you were supposed to submit your visa, 60 million entered your account. How did that money enter? Do you do drugs? These are you questions that every human being is going to ask you. Even if you tell me like that, I'm going to ask you that question. But what makes you think that the person reviewing your visa is a fish with fish brain? Right? So don't treat Canada visa officers as if they have fish brain. Treat them like humans. I always say, if something does not make sense to your neighbor, to your friend, it's not going to make sense to the visa officer. If it makes sense to your friend and to your neighbor, most likely it's going to make sense to the visa officer. Treat them like humans, all right? So when you are asking, why is Canada visa hard to get? It's not hard to get. I will say that the information is there, but people don't know. Because of this lack of information, people go ahead to do things anyhow. Whenever you see somebody telling you my visa was denied, ask them, what did you do? What did they tell you that you did? Receive sense. All right?